Hey, what's up guys? EYStream here to show you how to build a super easy working elevator or lift in your very own Minecraft world with no mods and no commands. Meaning this will work in survival for any version of Minecraft. It's awesome! In fact, it's so awesome you can even take your pets along for the ride. Come on, EY Pop, we're going on an adventure on a beautiful rocket ship. Well, not quite, we're not going on a rocket ship, we're going on my elevator here. Alright, so all you gotta do guys, chuck him on, we'll put EY Pop sitting down, hit the button, and shake this out. Guys, here we go. Up the elevator. Take me to the sky. Take me to the sky. Have a look at that. And voila, we got ourselves an elevator. EY Pop's all the way up here at the top. And of course, you can set him down on his own as well, right? You don't have to be with him. EY Pop's a big, strong boy. And of course, make sure to leave a like with your knee. Ha! I know none of you can do that. Wait, you can. You're telling me you can like this video with your knee? Okay, well, you're gonna have to prove it to me and do it in 3, 2, 1. Bam! Yeah, and of course, make sure to subscribe for more epic Minecraft builds. But until then, let's jump straight into this. Now, we're going to be building this in 2 phases. The first lot of items here is the guts. So that's what makes this bad boy work. And then our phase 2 of items is the decoration. And that's what makes our elevator look good. However, this is optional and you can actually decorate it however you want. So let's get started. First off, the guts. You're going to need 2 pistons, 6 sticky pistons, 6 observers, 8 slime blocks, 5 obsidian blocks, 4 quartz bricks, any type of button whatsoever. We're going to use polished blackstone buttons, and finally 10 pillar quartz blocks. So let's get started. Basically, wherever the front of your elevator is going to be, I'd recommend marking that out somehow. We can just put any random block. This is just going to help us a little bit later. Then what you want to do guys is you want to come up to your space and you want to place down 1 sticky piston at the back of your elevator, and then on the left here, we're going to place 1 piston like so. And this is going to be on the left side of your elevator when you're facing towards it, as you can see. Then we're going to put 2 slime blocks, 1 each above each of the pistons. Then what I want you guys to do is go ahead and destroy all the blocks here, just like so. This 6x2 space underneath the pistons and just over here. Then what we're going to do is grab your sticky piston, and at the back slime block, we're going to place 1 facing down. And then to the left of that, you're going to place down your normal piston like so, making this checkered pattern. And we're going to finish that checkered pattern in by going ahead and putting 1, 2 slime blocks just under like this. Now, it's super important, guys, that the bottom piston is on the bottom left corner of your elevator, and this piston on the right is here on the top right of your elevator. Otherwise, this thing isn't going to work. You can see it's the exact same with our demo model just over here. Now, we can go ahead and destroy this block, because that just helps me know which way is the front. Then what we're going to do here, guys, is grab our obsidian, and on the back 2 blocks here, you want to place 1, 2 blocks of obsidian, and then you're going to, just in front of that obsidian, break down 2 blocks further and place 1, 2 slime blocks just in front of those obsidian blocks. But it's super important you make sure you break the blocks underneath those slime blocks, or this whole thing is going to crash. The other thing you're going to have to do is break the block on the left of the slime block here and on the right, just like so. That's going to stop our slime blocks from, well, sticking onto everything and stopping our elevator from moving. Then what we're going to do here, guys, is you want to grab your quartz bricks, and we're going to place 1, 2 just in front of those 2 slime blocks here. Then you're going to grab your slime blocks out again, and we're going to place 1, 2 at the front of our elevator and place 2 more quartz bricks like so, just in front. And this is going to be the platform of our elevator. Now to add a little bit more of some redstone magic, what we're going to do is we're going to come around to the backside of our elevator here, guys. You want to come to the top left corner. If I can stop bouncing at the slime here, guys. Come to your top left corner, and you want to have your observer on this slime block, but facing out in this direction. You want to make sure the arrow is facing to the left, and so is the red dot. Then in front of that red dot, you want 1 sticky piston facing forward on your elevator. And in front of this, guys, we're going to place another observer, but you want to make sure it's facing into this slime block here. So to do that, you're going to need to stand just on the edge here and click the very edge of your piston so that you've got this arrow pointing into the slime block and this arrow here pointing out to that sticky piston. And so the face shows on the outside. It's super important you get the direction of these observers right, or this whole thing's gonna go and just simply not work. All right, now that we've got that here, guys, you want to come round to the back, and you want to come to this bottom corner here where our other slime block is, and we're gonna place another observer, this time with the red dot facing in the right direction. So you guys can see this arrow on the left faces the left, and the arrow on the right faces the right, and you're good to go there. Then what you want to do is come to the right side of your elevator on the front here where this slime block is, and we're gonna place 1, 2 observers just like that, making sure sure the arrow is facing in that right direction. Then you want to go ahead and destroy this observer behind here, and we're going to create something called an infinite redstone tick signal. Basically, when you place two observers back to back, as you guys can see, it creates this red pulsing redstone signal, and that goes on and on and on. And we're going to do that exact same thing just here on the right. So you want to come right next to your observer here, and in 3, 2, 1, place it down. And as you guys can see, that is going to send your elevator going sky high. Now, this thing is going to go as high as you let it go. It will just keep going and keep going. So what you want to do is wherever you want it to stop, you're going to place down one obsidian block above the slime like that. As you guys can see, it stops where the obsidian is. Now, you can do that before you send off your elevator or after. It depends what you want to do. If you've already decided how high your floor is going to be, you can place your obsidian in like so. Or if you want to just send your elevator as high as it goes and then wait for it to stop it, you can do it this way as well. But what we're going to do now is destroy that obsidian and actually place it on these back two blocks here, just so it looks a bit more aesthetically pleasing. All right, now we want to be able to send it down. So to do that, guys, you want to come to the top right corner of your elevator here, guys. I'm going to place one sticky piston facing towards this observer here that is next to this arrow. We're going to grab just any random button, and you want to place this on the sticky piston and activate that so it pulls our observer back here. Then we're going to destroy that button like so. Now we're going to go ahead and make a little bit of a frame for our elevator. So grab out your pillar quartz bricks, and we're going to just build here on the right-hand side, 4 blocks up, and then on the left side as well, once again, 4 blocks up. And because of my OCD, we're going to change those down at the bottom. So you've got about a little elevator frame going on. However, what we actually want to do is in this top left corner, just here where this slime block is, we're going to break this block out, and you want to grab a sticky piston and place it facing backwards towards this observer here on the left. So you guys have a look from the top down view. You want this sticky piston here on the left, on this top left slime block facing towards this observer here. And this is where we're going to be able to activate our elevator to go up and down. So we're going to go ahead, put a button on that piston, go ahead and activate it, and voila, check it out, guys. Our elevator will start heading down. Have a look at that beautiful piston and slime block magic, and it will go ahead, hit the bottom just like so, and we're good. Now we need to build a frame here at the bottom so we can send it back up. So to do that, guys, once again, we're going to grab our pillar quartz blocks, and you want to place 3 on either side, so you've got a nice little frame going on. But then on the bottom right corner where this slime block is, you're going to break out this pillar quartz blocks here, guys, and you want to place a sticky piston facing in towards this observer here, guys. Really, really important. We'll get you from the top down view. It's on the bottom right hand corner here. This sticky piston on the right of this slime blocks facing in towards this observer here. Then this observer you've got hanging out on the side, we're going to destroy that. We don't need that anymore. All right, now we can go ahead, place our polished blackstone button on this, and bang, guys, we are actually done the guts of this elevator. It will now go up and down with no problems at all. However, it does look just a little bit odd. Now, obviously, guys, we've gone ahead and you can cover up the elevator with a wall or however you want to decorate it like so, but I am gonna show you a cute little decoration I like to put on the front of my elevator just to make them look a little bit nicer. So let's go ahead and switch on to phase 2 of the items here, guys. We are going to need 4 pillar quartz blocks, 4 magenta glazed terracotta, 4 chiseled quartz blocks, 4 birch buttons, 8 quartz stairs, and finally 4 end rods. And basically, we're going to be just prettying up the frames of our elevator here. So let's start on the bottom, guys. What you want to go ahead and do is we're going to place 1 pillar quartz block here, and we're going to place 1 here on the piston, which means we're going to need to move this button. So destroy that for now. We're going to place our pillar quartz here, and you want to jump on the left, and you want to place 1 arrow facing down, and then on the right-hand side, we're going to place 1 arrow facing up. I think this adds to the elevator because it's like, you know, the elevator goes up and down. It's just a cute little touch that I think your friends will think looks really cool, and it's just impressive. It makes you look like a professional builder. Then above the left side here, we're going to place 1 chiseled quartz brick and do the exact same thing on the right-hand side. Grab out your quartz stairs here, guys, and next to your quartz brick, we're going to place 1, 2 upside down like so, and then on the top of the left one here, you're going to place 1 facing inwards, do the exact same thing on the right-hand side, and then go ahead and place end rods facing in towards each other. And that's going to make a really nice entrance to your lift. As you can see, it's the same one we're using over here with one minor change. We've got the birch buttons on the center of each of those quartz bricks just to add a little bit of extra detail. We're going to grab our polished blackstone button now, and we're going to move it so it's just on this quartz brick here. Now we're going to go ahead and we're going to do something very, very similar up the top. We're going to grab our pillar quartz bricks, guys, and build 1, 2 and 1, 2 on the right hand side. We're going to need to get rid of that polished blackstone button for the time being. You want to grab your magenta glazed terracotta. We're going to have one going on the left here and then one going on the right. So you've got your down and up arrows. Grab out your quartz stairs. We're going to place these facing upside down here. On the left, chiseled quartz brick. On the right, chiseled quartz brick, just like it is downstairs, guys. Then, of course, grab your quartz stairs left and right facing in towards each other. And, of course, the end rods to finish it off. Oh, don't forget the birch buttons. And then place back your polished polished Blackstone button just here on the arrow. And now, guys, let's go ahead and test this out inside. We click the Blackstone button. All right, here we go, guys. We're going down the elevator. The chances of this working are 100% because I've tested this and it works. We've seen it work. We're going to go ahead, get down here to the bottom of our elevator. And voila, guys, check that out. We've reached the bottom. And of course, we can send it straight back up. Now, that there, guys, is our working elevator. It's super easy and simple, probably the easiest elevator design around. If you want more easy builds just like this, I don't got to tell you what to do. You know what to do. Go subscribe right now. Leave a like, guys. I will see you in the next one. Stay awesome. And until then, EOS Stream out. Bye.